Well, what's the connection between inverse tangent and our best friend maybe? Well, it doesn't have like direct connection, but it's like a long distance relative, you will see. Because we know that if we differentiate inverse tangent, we get what? 1 over 1 plus x squared. So if we integrate 1 over 1 plus x squared, we get inverse tangent. So the strategy is, I'll just put down a note right here on the side for you guys. If we integrate 1 over 1 plus x squared, this will give us inverse tangent of x. All right? And yes, I do know to put a plus c. All right, so we will just come up with a series for the 1 over 1 plus x squared and integrate that. Yes. All right, so go ahead. Perhaps I'll just write down the best friend again. 1 over 1 minus x. This right here is the sum as n goes from 0 to infinity. X to the nth power, absolute value of x is less than 1. And now, 1 over 1 plus x squared. This is the same as saying 1 over 1 minus parentheses negative x squared, like this. Okay, and then I'm just going to enter this right here. So we have the sum as n goes from 0 to infinity, parentheses that, and we have the negative x squared to the nth power. Enter this into the absolute value. Absolute value of negative x squared is less than 1. Good. Now, work this out. You see that this is, of course, 1 over 1 plus x squared. And simplify this a little bit. This is the series as n goes from 0 to infinity. We have negative 1 to the nth power. So I'll put this down nicely. And then this is x to the 2 nth power, like this. And of course, when you have the absolute value of negative, it doesn't matter. And then you can take the square root like what we did earlier. So all in all, we get the absolute value of x is less than 1. Okay? So just some simple algebra for that. Now, it's time for us to integrate. We will just integrate. Integrate. Left-hand side, inverse tangent. So here we have the inverse tangent. Right-hand side, first of all, put on C plus. Unfortunately, we cannot say plus C in this case. Yeah? C plus, and here, don't worry. Go ahead and add 1 to the power. This is the new power divided by that. And man, we can integrate power series all day, all night long, right? Okay, so here we have the sum. As n goes from 0 to infinity, again, when you integrate, you don't lose any term, right? When you differentiate, maybe sometimes you want to start with n is equal to 1, etc. Anyway, here we have negative 1 to the nth power over 2n plus 1, and then this is x to the 2n plus 1's power, like this. And yes, you know it. We have to find out what the c is. And yes, you know it. We are going to pick x equals 0. And then put it here, we get, to use the purple pen now, this right here is the inverse tangent of 0. And of course, that's going to be 0. No big deal. Put a c plus series, n goes from 0 to infinity, negative 1 to the n over 2n plus 1. You put a 0 in here, so you have 0 to the 2n plus 1's power. This right here is equal to c plus, well, when n is equal to 0, the first term is 0 to the first power times all that, which is 0. Likewise, the next term when n is 1, you get 0, and so on, so on, so on. So you get 0 for this series. In another word, c is, of course, equal to 0. That means right here, it's equal to 0. Okay, so we're going to do what we did earlier, so just kind of stay strong, okay? So let me just write this down. Here we have the inverse tangent of x, which is that we have the sum as n goes from 0 to infinity, and we have negative 1 to the nth power over 2n plus 1, and we have x to the 2n plus 1's power. Well, the radius of convergence will stay the same because we just integrate this thing right here, right? So r will still be 1. And that means I will be going from negative 1 to 1. But this time, we don't know what will happen at the endpoints. So go ahead and do the check. Here we go. This is the check. When x is equal to negative 1. Again, do not just put in the function, okay? You always have to put in the series and just observe. Unless you can say, okay, the function doesn't work, the series doesn't work. But, you know, in this case, inverse tangent, it always works. So don't do that. So put this right here. So here we have the series. N goes from 0 to infinity. And this is negative 1 to the nth power over 2n plus 1. And here we have parentheses negative 1 to the 2n plus 1's power, like this. OK, here, what do we have? This is the sum n goes from 0 to infinity. This is negative 1 to the n over 2n plus 1. And of course, we can separate this. This is the same as negative 1 to the 2n times negative 1 to the first. But this right here is nicely equal to just 1. This is a negative 1. I can put it all the way in the front. And this is the sum n goes from 0 to infinity. So we have negative 1 to the nth power. And this is 1 over 2n plus 1, like this. Right? So that's how you do it. Then, does this converge or diverge? What kind of series is this? Alternating. OK, good. So take this to be the bn. And let's just go ahead and do the check. First check, does bn go to 0? So as n goes to infinity, bn, which is 1 over 2n plus 1, put infinity to here, does it go to 0? Yes, it does. So of course, checks. Secondly, do we have a decreasing bn? Well, we don't know yet, so let's put this down. Put n plus 1 here. So notice, put n plus 1 here, OK? 1 over 2 times n plus 1. And then plus 1, is this less than or equal to the original bn? Well, just work this out real quick. So here you get, just cross multiply if you would like. I find students like to cross multiply. So this times that is 2n plus 1. Is this less than or equal to, this right here is 2n plus 2 plus 1. So it's, of course, plus 3. And if you look at this, of course, it checks. So again, this right here, let me just write it down here. It converges by AST. OK, so it converges by AST. OK, so we can come here and include negative 1. Very good. Now, don't forget to check when x is equal to positive 1. Yeah. Anyway, put a 1 in here. So we are looking at the sum as n goes from 0 to infinity. And here we have negative 1 to the nth power over 2n plus 1 times 1 raised to the 2n plus 1 power. The good thing is that this is always 1. Yeah? So we're looking at the sum as n goes from 0 to infinity. I will just write it as negative 1 to the nth power. And then this is multiplied by 1 over 2n plus 1, like this. Yes, this is exactly the same as that part. This right here has a negative. It's a negative of finite value. This is just a positive. So I will just tell you this right here converges as well, of course, because we can do the same thing, converges by AST, right? Therefore, we come here and include positive 1 as well. Right? So we are done. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the inverse tangent of x. Take a look. I know, another monster question, but this is what we have to go through in Calc 2. Right? So have a look. In the meantime, let me tell you guys what I'm drinking. It's this thing, OK? Just black tea.